Welcome to Softimage. This series of videos covers some of the basic interactions and operations in Softimage to help new users get up and running quickly. In this first video, we'll go over some of the settings that you should make before you start to work. When you start Softimage, by default it displays a net view window with links to useful information and other resources. It also lets you choose your interaction model. The interaction model determines the keyboard shortcuts used for various commands and tools, as well as various animation and other preferences. The Softimage interaction model is more flexible because it uses the S key to navigate the camera, leaving the Alt key free to modify other keystrokes. But if you're already familiar with Maya, you'll be more comfortable with the Maya interaction model. For this tutorial, we'll be using the Softimage model, but we'll point out major differences with the Maya model whenever relevant. You can switch interaction models at any time from the File menu, but note that specific preferences that you've changed in the meantime might get reset. If you're familiar with 3ds Max, you can choose the 3ds Max keymap. This changes the keyboard shortcuts to be similar to those used in 3ds Max, and can be used with the other preferences set by either interaction model. You can display the current keymap in a web browser, whether it's a predefined keymap or a customized one. This lets you print out or search the page using Ctrl F. One of the first things you should do is create or connect to a project so that you can save and reload your scenes. A project is a set of folders for storing your scenes, textures, rendered images, and other assets. The exercise samples and face robot projects are in your project list already, but depending on your file permissions, you won't be able to save to these locations. Click New Project to specify a folder name and path for a new project. However, for this tutorial, we'll add an existing project so that you can load a scene with something more interesting to look at. When opening a scene, you can use the Paths button to quickly switch between the projects in your list. There's one last thing you should set before you start doing any work. Set the default output format in your preferences. This controls both the picture size and the frame rate. These values are used by default for new scenes that you create. You can load presets for standard formats or set custom values for individual options. After you've created a scene, the settings are saved in the scene file. You can change the scene's picture size in the scene's render settings, and you can change the scene's frame rate in its playback control options. Starting with the correct frame rate before you do any animation means that you won't need to adjust timings later. So now that we've got a project and a scene, we're almost ready to start work. In the next video, we'll go over the interface.